everybody, and welcome to the 370th episode of Ranger Chronicles. I am your host, Charlie Niemeyer, and today we are watching three episodes of Power Rangers SPD. And they are Zapped and the two-part Reflection. So, without any further ado, we're going to jump right into our first episode. But we're going to get this episode started here in 3, 2, 1, go. Zapped was the 23rd episode of Power Rangers SPD. It first aired on July 25th, 2005, written by Stan Berkowitz and directed by John Lang. Stan Berkowitz. I know that name. I mean, he probably has done other stuff and I didn't look him up, but he was big in the like DC animated universe. Like Justice League Unlimited. Ooh. Oh, we got a new opening. Duh. I haven't been paying attention to it. I was talking. And I see the Battleizer.
To an exciting day filled with adventure, romance, and a financial windfall.
Ka-ching! I could use some extra spending.
So can Sam talk when he's in the ball of light form?
Hey, do me.
Alright, what's your sign?
It's hard to say. My mother went into labor on a Trans-Pacific airline, so I was born day, and then when we landed, it was the day before. So I was actually born the day before I was born.
Here. It says, today you're going to be confused, and tomorrow, and the next day.
Oh, boy. Uh-oh.
Later, guys.
Sure. Kruger gets Omega Ranger, and we get Sparky the Nightlight.
Like he's Kruger's long-lost son or something.
But he couldn't be his actual son because of the whole interspecies aspect.
Come on, yeah. Guys. Sam's new, and he's from the future. Of course. I'm sure Kruger's just trying to gain some valuable information, that's all.
And we're not valuable?
Sky!
Apparently I am.
Yes, sir. I need Omega for a while. See that his daily duties are covered.
Yes, sir.
Funny.
Yes, sir.
What?
I wonder if that footage they were watching was from Ninja Storm.
Isn't always predictable.
Oh, no.
But I guarantee. My next illusion will work. My courageous assistant, Al.
Hey.
Make a perilous journey.
The voice of this guy sounds an awful lot like Piggy when he's not being Piggy. Most of him. Oh, we totally saw that. Hello, Morgana.
Quite the right word. Maybe hated is more like it.
Oh,
yeah, pretty close.
We haven't heard that before.
The name's Morgana. You're really bad, but you do have potential. With a little help from me, you could be the world's greatest magician. All you need is a little guidance and this magic wand.
Oh, right. A magic wand.
Yes, a magic wand.
Where'd he go?
What did you do to him?
I made him invisible.
Wow.
Are you
Wait.
Sure?
Nobody gives away something like this. What do you
oh, hardly
want?
Hardly anything. Maybe one day you could help me out should something arise. But in the meantime, you can just enjoy.
Ooh, sounds good.
Oh, hello.
Oh, this isn't good.
I cannot see my feet here.
Oh.
Gold.
Oh, it actually did work.
All taken in broad daylight. While people were present, no one saw anything. The thefts have been going on for weeks, and...
Where is it, sir?
411 West Rose. Omega, I want you to go and make
sure... No, I'll go.
Sir.
So... Did we just jump forward several weeks or something?
Oh,
Man, talk about tailgating.
SPD, which way did the thieves go?
Hey, I was gonna say that.
Hey!
Then go ahead.
Fine, I will. SPD, which way did the thieves go?
It's hard to say, really? I didn't actually see them.
It's Commander.
I just saw cash floating out of my store. Guys!
Wow, he is everywhere in this series.
Bridge, what are you doing?
I think your friend's going to need a little help.
You're kidding. I'm a magician, not a fighter. Oh,
fine, I'll do it. Men.
I thought she was going to only use it in the future. Maybe. It is kind of cool that they can do that in broad daylight without having to worry about hiding or something. Oh, we still gotta get his morph, right? Ouch. That was a wall. Not as sunny over where Omega and Sky are. Wow, two shots took out three good robots. That's pretty good.
Better join them.
Yeah. Did he morph without having his glove on? That can't be good. Wonder if that has an effect on something. Probably not. Oh, unnecessary flipping! And screwdriver! Oh, no, that actually helped.
Where do you think you're going?
That's SPD down there. I didn't sign up for this.
Remember,
that's a good point.
You promised to help me out should something arise. Well, something
hasn't she
arose.
Hasn't he already been helping? Or does he want to rob? Ooh, that was a good hit, I guess.
You have the right to remain silent.
Yeah, yeah. Like I haven't heard that before.
Interrogate him. Ow.
Ah,
now,
interrogations.
Now, we'd be easier on you if you just tell us who else is involved. We're betting you're working with somebody else. All you gotta do is tell us who, and we'll take 4-5 years off your sentence. What do you say?
Oh, lovely.
You better tell us what we want to know, or else.
Did you have onions for lunch?
It must have been tough for you, Al. Never getting a break from anyone. Me, I had it all. Great parents, a good education, a credit card, and you...
Sugar plum fairies again.
How can you ever amount to anything with your skin so... scaly?
Scaly? I am a lizard. Can you bring the blue guy back in?
Going to annoy him with music?
And performs. It's called Me. Because it's all about her. You like it?
Seriously, can you bring the blue guy back? Please.
What does he know? He's a lizard.
But then again, true. Why should he help us? Prison is safe, secure. But is anything ever really truly secure? Security can only come from one place.
Oh, Bridge.
Just a false sense of security. And what does security really give us?
Stop! I can't take it anymore. I'll talk.
It worked.
Helped by some dame named Morgana.
He's good.
Grum, Commander?
Yes. He's up to something.
Well, they're starting to get... Well, not starting, but they've been getting really good with the mouth movements. That looked very much like he said that. Uh-oh!
Okay, I'm leaving now.
You will obtain a scientist for me. If I took her myself...
A scientist?
It would call too much attention to my plan.
Your plan?
Never mind about that. Now either you help me, or be...
Vaporized. He can do it with his eyes closed.
Broodwing will sell you a robot to help you.
I don't have that kind of money.
Then he'll give you one.
Give? I don't give anything away for free.
Arguing. Maybe?
Do as I order. I've given you enough money for your ineffectual weaponry.
Yes, my emperor.
First, I want you to do a little charity work for me.
You'll get yours, Grum. I promise you that.
Ooh.
Benefit for New Tech University Science Center, featuring the great Mysticon. I have a bad feeling about this.
So do I. That's why I'm sending Sam to do some undercover work.
Sam? Again? But...
Do you have a problem with my decision, cadet?
This reminds me of the, episode where... The first episode after Shadow came in.
I don't think this is such a great
It's like,
idea, guys.
Everyone's gotta get used to this. And gotta get used to having the new guy around.
Backup. Right. Backup he didn't ask for, and Kruger didn't assign.
Yeah, but it's still backup. It's kind of like the whole tree falling in the forest thing.
I'm gonna go check over here. You guys go on without me.
All right. Save your seat.
Oh, and who are you?
I'm applying for the new assistant position. I love magic. I really love money, and I won't ask questions.
Oh, you're hired.
Who? Simple.
Well, excuse me, my dear.
Except Morgana knows that she's the Pink Ranger.
What is it?
Your new assistant. She's SPD.
Ooh, she is so fired.
No.
She's so fired.
Here's what you're going to do.
Everything's just fine. In fact, we're going to do our first trick right now. You will do everything I say.
Uh-oh.
Understood?
Understood.
Well, her eyes are really blue.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. I am the great Mysticon, and thank you for donating to the university's science program. Now, for our main event, let the magic begin. And now, with a little help from my lovely assistant, on with the show!
Oh, Sam see something, maybe? Oh, she lost her hat!
It's Sid.
Wow.
Deep undercover.
Very good, Z.
I didn't know Sid could do magic.
Abracadabra!
Oh! How did they do that?
We need a volunteer from the audience. Perhaps someone who's not quite so eager. How about you, man? Yes, you. Please don't be shy. It's for the university.
Did she put her hand up?
And what is your name?
Dr. Helen Tyler Jones.
Step right inside for me.
Oh.
You'll be fine.
Grum's had diamonds stolen, iridium, even sand. But I don't see how this magician fits in.
Sam?
Mysticon's just pulled a woman named Dr. Helen Tyler Jones out of the audience. Does her name mean anything to you?
Dr. Helen Tyler Jones. Just one of the world's leading microbiologists. But what would Grum want with her?
Those things he's been stealing. He just might want someone to combine them for his
Whoa.
Evil purpose. I'll send the other rangers.
An ongoing subplot?
They're what?
Uh-oh.
Way, doctor.
He's pretty ticked.
Mind your step. I will now tap this container once, twice, three times, and voila!
El Gonzo!
Back.
Remember, give to the university.
And Sid?
Whoever could that be?
SPD emergency!
How did he knock on the door without his hands? Where's the doctor? Oh, there she is.
Hold her right there.
Stop them.
Oh, looks like it's getting ready to rain there.
You too. Good girl.
She took her shoes off.
SPD emergency, okay?
Yes. Well, that broke it.
What? Where am I?
In the middle of a fight.
What else is new?
Oh, that, yeah. Oh, that was pretty cool. That worked. They actually stopped. Oh, they saved the doctor. I'm starting to notice some unnecessary flipping this episode. Oh, wow. Biggin.
He looks like a tough one.
I've reconfigured the Megazord to combine if necessary. I just hope it works.
Okay. Six-part Megazord now? Yep. Oh, maybe not. Duh. Whoops. Well, he's really fast. Also doesn't help that you keep stopping right before you swipe. You know, because of the film cut. How did that not work?
Now, together, okay.
Uh-oh.
Watch where you're going. Me? It wasn't my fault. You should have been following guys. Come on, let's rush them both at once.
Right.
Let's do it, Sam.
Yeah, just blow up some buildings, no problem.
We've got to combine the Megazords.
I don't know. Are you sure we're ready for this, Cat?
You've been trained, Rangers. You are ready.
Deltamex Megazord sequencing initiated.
All right.
Let's Interesting.
Hang on, everybody.
Weird way to introduce it.
Deltamex Megazord.
Oh, that's pretty cool. Look at all the lights.
Yeah!
I don't know how that's going to help, though.
Remember, Rangers, there's a hyperspeed mode that might come in useful.
Ah, hyperspeed mode. Okay.
Don't scare me. Boosters, go! How did they do that?
Gee, I don't know. Hey, they finally landed a blow.
Judgment time. No, wait. None of this was my idea. I was forced into it by that Grum fellow and Morgana. I mean, sure, I'm a crook, but I can be reformed. I know I can. I've been reformed many times.
Nope. I've been reformed many times.
Full power.
Jeez. Excuse me?
Whatever.
They did it. They did it. You don't seem too happy.
I'm not.
Uh-oh.
You deliberately violated my direct order.
It was my fault, sir. It was my idea. Just wanted to show you that we're as good as Rangers as Sam.
Who said you weren't? Not me. However, Sam is a very special individual.
We know that, sir. It's just you've been spending an awful lot of time with him.
Spending a lot of time with him to get him acclimated to this space, this time. I did this knowing that you are fully confident and self-sustaining. Was I mistaken?
No, sir. It's just that we were a little...
jealous.
There is no room for jealousy here. You are my Rangers. You are my team. You will just have to trust that. Trust in yourselves. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Aww.
A robot that wasn't paid for. That was my robot. My money. My loss. Grum will pay dearly for crossing me.
Has his chest always lit up like that? Alright, let's see. Mr. Barney Duncan and Al! He was both of them. That's cool. Yes, Barney Duncan is the voice of, you might remember Eric telling us not that long ago. He is Piggy. He also will be back next season without the makeup. But that was cool. And yeah, Stan Berkowitz, he has a long career outside of Power Rangers as far as writing, including the DC animated universe. So having him on here is actually really cool. All right, well, that's going to do it for this one, so we're going to take a quick break, and I'll be right back with our second episode.
We'll be right back to Power Rangers SPD, part of JetX on ABC Family.
Attention, Rangers. Name, rank, and genetic powers.
Sydney Drew.
I am
the SPD Pink Ranger.
Fist of Iron.
Freeze! You are under arrest.
To protect and serve the galaxy.
Power Rangers SPD.
Go!
Monday nights at 7:30, 6:30 Central. Part of JetX on Toon Disney.
Rangers dismissed.
Now, back to Power Rangers SPD. Part of JetX on ABC Family.
And we're back. And we're ready to start our second episode for the day. Or the episode. Second episode for this episode. See, you might not listen to it all in one day. I don't know. You have your own lives. Anyway, okay, so let's get started here on our next one. Reflection Part 1. We'll do this in 3, 2, 1, go.
SPD Emergency.
Reflection Part 1 was the 24th episode of Power Rangers SPD. It first aired on August 12, 2005, written by Jackie Marchand and directed by John Lang. It's almost disappointing that they don't have, like, a spot for the little ball of light. I mean, it makes sense, obviously, but it just... It'd be kind of funny. By the way, that one scene of them all walking, I believe that's from the finale. So, yeah. If you're ever curious how far ahead they film these things.
This is going to be beyond incredible. Oh, can I do the honors, please?
Okay, but be careful.
SPD Battleizer, engage!
Oh, that didn't work.
I see the Battleizer's not quite finished.
A temporary setback, sir. I'm sure we'll have it fully functional right away.
See that you do.
What a spectacular day. I can't believe we have it all to ourselves.
No disasters. No sirens.
Oh, is this not a futuristic thing without a sound effect?
Whatever. I just wish Sam were here to enjoy it.
Where is he?
Kruger sent him to check out disturbance in the Strata Quadrant. He should be back soon, though.
Wherever he is, can't be as nice as New Tech City.
Sky, are you actually enjoying yourself?
It's a perfect day. What's not to enjoy?
Uh-oh.
Got it.
Well, that's
sorry to
weird.
Horn in on your fun.
I thought we already caught this creep.
We did. I still have the bruises. It's Reinix.
Let me out.
Well, looks like we're gonna have to catch him again. Let's
the horn
up.
Guy. Well, it's nice to have Sid in the middle. That's cool.
Catch me if you can.
Where'd he go?
Hey.
Hey. Okay, what is this?
Hello, Green Ranger.
Hey.
Reunion day?
I remember you. You're Hydrax, the Phrenovian.
That's right.
Ha! You okay, Bridge?
Oh, no. Don't tell me. It's gotta be Bugglesworth.
You got it. Reunited and it feels so good.
You know, it's kind of funny. It's almost like...
He's gone too?
What are we doing? Sinister Six version here?
Maybe they busted out of their containment cards.
Kat said those cards were foolproof and there was no chance of escape.
And I was right. They're all still here.
I don't get it. We saw them running around in the city.
Yeah, you can't be in two places at the same time.
Excuse me.
Well, you can, but you're one of a kind. I mean,
this is a very serious problem. We simply don't have the manpower to recapture every criminal in our files. I want you to search the city grid for any disturbances.
Jack, I'm gonna need your morpher to upload a new weapon system.
Ah, you got it, Kat. Just wait till you see it. It's totally awesome. Right, Rick? Excellent, Cap. We'll need it if more of those goons show up. You can upgrade mine next.
The technology was designed to work in conjunction with the Red Ranger's morpher only.
Oh.
Sorry, Sky.
No big deal.
Should be really amazing, Jack.
Thanks.
Just when you Sky. Thought I was getting over it.
Sky. Chosen to be the Red Ranger, but you gotta get over it.
Listen, I know I had a problem with that at first, and I still don't always agree with some of your methods, but you've done a good job as Red Ranger. This is not about you.
Then what's it about?
All I ever wanted to
be Dad.
Was just like him. A Red Ranger.
So your father was an incredible guy.
He was my hero.
This guy. Heroes come in all colors.
Oh, it's like a double version of that. That was cool.
What is it?
This is Murloc. He's one of the most brilliant masterminds ever. He's had his hand in every dirty deal, and he knows every shady character in the galaxy.
He's been in a specially designed maximum security cell on Gamma Orion. Conventional confinement methods have proven ineffectual since he has the capability of escaping through any reflective surface.
I see. But what do you want me to do?
Interrogate Murloc. Find out what he knows about these duplicate aliens.
Don't worry, sir. You've got the right man for the job.
Good luck, cadet.
Sir, I've read Murlock's file. It says he was the last to...
I know that.
Did you tell Sky?
No, I did not, and you're not to say anything either.
He has a right to know.
Yes, but not now. Am I clear?
Interesting.
Are you aware of our security measures?
I know.
You know, I don't know if y'all have seen this. But that totally looked like the planet Skaro from the 1996 Doctor Who TV movie. Even with the other planets in the background. Oh, look at that. They've even got to do the glasses because your eyes are reflected.
What am I in for?
Yeah. That place is short. Well, he is tall, but still.
A visitor. What a rare treat.
This isn't a social visit. I'm here on official SPD business. I want to ask you some questions.
What a rude young man you are. Now, I don't think I'll talk to you at all.
Oh, you'll talk. I've got all the time in the world. And by the looks of things, so do you.
You're a tough one, aren't you? All business, no nonsense.
Never mind about me.
He's got a cool voice.
I don't see why I should tell you anything. Goodbye, cadet, whoever you are.
This is important. What's it gonna take to get some information out of you?
I don't ask for much. You see, I'm a collector of sorts. I'll give you information, and you give me a small something for my collection.
Okay, whatever, deal. But no mirrors.
No, nothing like that. Now tell me about these criminals you seek.
Exact duplicates of aliens we've already captured have shown up throughout the city. How is this possible?
You say you're looking for several criminals, but did you see them all together?
No.
Then it sounds like you're dealing with that scoundrel Slate.
Slate?
As in blank slate. He's a copycat criminal who's capable of mimicking the exact likeness of others. All he needs is a data scan of their genetic code. My guess is that Broodwing is more than happy to supply him that, for a price.
So we're not up against an army of old enemies, just one new one.
Exactly. Oh, cadet, don't forget about our deal.
If you told me the truth, I'll keep my word.
Uh-oh.
Well, wait until you see what I have for you today, Slate. The genetic code data from the most powerful warrior the Rangers have battled. If you want it, it won't come cheap.
Give it to me. I'll add it to my repertoire.
Who is it?
A copycat criminal. That makes perfect sense.
So what we gotta do
is... samurai, maybe?
Guy who was golden.
Excellent job, Tate. You didn't fall prey to Murloc's tricks.
Wasn't a problem, sir. Just kept focused on the task at hand.
Jack, Sunuku.
More like a Sunuku wannabe. Though I don't know why anyone would want to be Sunuku. He's totally ugly. Plus, if I remember correctly, he has really bad breath.
That's gotta be Slate.
And this time we got his number. Let's bag this copycat.
Whoa, 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 you didn't morph first. Also, where's Sam? Oh yeah, Sam's not back yet.
We've had enough of your games. You're nothing but a big fake.
And just who am I? Am I Sunuku? Or Bugglesworth? Or maybe I'm...
the Fernovian bank robber.
Hey!
Hydrax. Or I could be...
the dreaded Rhinox!
Perhaps I'm General to Mars.
At this point, I don't care.
Hey! Meet your true enemy, Slate.
Wow. Really looks like he saved a lot of money on this costume. You know what he reminds me of? It kind of reminds me of Zed, the evil Zed Rangers. Ooh.
Okay, so you got in a couple of lucky hits. But I know the one creature you won't be so happy to see.
Devastation is back!
It's Devastation!
Not really.
Really?
Good imitation. Slate has many warriors to choose from, thanks to me.
I don't recall authorizing this plan. It would serve you well to remember who is the Emperor around here?
I thought you would be pleased with my idea.
When I want your ideas, I'll blast them out of you. Morgana.
Those eyes are crazy, man.
Oh, goody, I get to help Slate battle the Rangers.
Yes, but I also need you to bring me an essential tool in our conquest of SPD. Bring me Piggy.
Piggy? Oh,
yes,
no.
Piggy. He will be the key to everything.
Fury Circle!
Oh, you're kidding!
You know what to do!
It all works? You know, I don't remember this work happening before, but man, the Sentai footage is a lot more saturated. Oh, I do remember this happening before now that I think about it. Oh, we've seen this robot before. I remember the mouth and the tummy. So, I'm wondering, without looking. Oh, look at that! But I'm wondering if they took this footage, or the footage for this episode from the Sentai, is before Deca Bright, or Deca Light? Deca. Take a break. Was introduced in the Sentai. Wouldn't be the first time they've gone back. Yeah, there is a Deca Bright too, so I'm not completely dumb. Just partially.
What are you going to do with me?
You and all your identities are going away for a long time.
Jack!
Watch it!
Morgana! I don't think so, Ranger boy. Grum has a little present for Slate.
Right!
Oh, that's nifty.
Oh, great! Multiple maniacs!
Talk about deja vu!
And deja vu, deja vu, deja vu, deja vu, deja vu.
Not even the Rangers can defeat that many warriors at once.
Now, obviously, it's not happening, but this would be like a perfect time for like a team-up episode or something. Wow, she went flying. Correct me if I'm wrong, but shouldn't he be getting sliced in half with that water? Well, that's weird. Now the American footage is looking really saturated. What is going on with the color? That is an awkward flipping. Whoa.
It's over, Ranger.
What was that? Oh.
No dogs allowed.
You could see the ramp. Whoa! I don't think we've ever seen Doggy do that.
Ah!
finished.
Not yet.
Ouch. Okay, well, here we go. The Omega Ranger morph are recolored. This will be a running thing for a few years, actually. This is known as the Battle Thong. So the question is, how is this supposed to do much? Because really, it just gives him like a couple shoulder stuff and a sword. Actually, a baton. I guess it's supposed to upgrade his output power too? His HP, if you will. Now, the SPD Battleizer is the first and only one to actually be adapted back into the Sentai. Even though Dekaranger had aired by the time this had come out, they still returned for a team-up with Magiranger, our Mystic Force, and they actually used the Battleizer in it. I think they even call it a Battleizer. Oh, who does he think he is? A Titanium Ranger with that kick? Come on. Oh, two in a row. That has got to hurt. Ooh, nice kick. Now, I think in the... And I don't remember because it's been a long time since I've seen it. But I believe that in the Dekaranger case, I think this was the only mode to be used. And I was actually hoping that they were going to be the first time to actually use Power Ranger footage in a Sentai. But no, they created their own footage for him suiting up. But it was obviously Rick, so that's cool. Wow. Now you're probably wondering how they got all of that out of Rick. And the answer is, shut up.
This can be a thing.
Go, Jack!
Way to go!
Excellent work, Jack.
Yeah.
Want some more? Didn't think so.
They're not gonna, like, arrest her or something? They're just gonna let her get away? Also, she didn't get piggy.
Just like I said I'd be.
Your integrity is to be commended.
Yes.
I don't want to be here any longer than I have to be. Now, what is it you want for your collection?
I collect memories. Sad memories.
What?
In exchange for the information I gave you, you must tell me your worst memory.
No. Forget it.
We had a deal, Ranger.
Ooh. How did he know he was a Ranger?
My dad was a Power Ranger, too. He was the Red Ranger. He was a great father.
but he made a vow to protect the innocent. When people were in danger, he was always ready to fight.
He's got a Time Force morpher on, too.
One day he got the call. They say he saved dozens of people and fought until the bitter end.
Oh, they added SPD things to the side of the helmet. Oh, look, and they even changed the logo. Oh, and there's the damaged. Is that?
Never saw him again.
I think that's really the damaged one that you actually used in Time Force.
What a horrible memory. I can only imagine how hard that was for you.
I'll never forget it.
Of course not. Thank you, Ranger. That's the most amusing story I've heard in years.
What?
Oh, yes. I have to admit, I've heard some sorry tales, but yours is truly one of the saddest. It will be the most treasured in my collection.
You're a monster!
You think?
Uh-oh. Okay, so technically he's out, right? Right. But, hey, Campbell Cooley. I just saw Campbell Cooley's name. I didn't remember seeing him before. But then again, but he got out. I'm confused. He got out, but he's in that teardrop that fell to the ground. So he's kind of stuck, right? I cannot wait to see how they explain this. All right, so let me ask you this. What do you think, since I don't know if you remember this, but, you know, Kat had a problem with Sky going to see this guy in the first place. What do you think are the odds that this reflection guy had something to do with the death of Sky's dad? Could be interesting. So we're going to find that out right now in 3, 2, 1. Go.
SPD emergency.
Reflection Part 2 was the 25th episode of Power Rangers SPD. It also aired on August 12, 2005, written by Jackie Marchand and directed by John Lang. So obviously we had a 1-hour premiere. That's cool. You know, the eyes on that, in the intro here, Doggy's eyes never look at the camera. You know, it's interesting. I wonder if the people that made the show weren't big into the Battleizer at all, because the Battleizer is going to be kind of made obsolete in the next two-parter, which we'll be watching next time.
I'll give you information, and you give me a small.
Is that why he's not in a card?
Okay, whatever, deal. But no mirrors.
I've heard some sorry tales, but yours is truly one of the saddest.
I like the little smile there, the smirk. Careful. Careful.
Following Murloc.
Oh, don't. What are you going to do?
Planetary mayhem.
Looks like it's written in Japanese.
Blah, blah, blah. Life in prison, blah, blah, blah. Believed to be responsible for the... Oh.
I think I called it.
No.
Hey, Sky. Look, I'm real sorry to hear about Murloc escaping, but, you know, I'm sure you'll catch him, which is good, because, after all, he is responsible for your father's...
Oh, he did not know that.
Didn't know.
Good job, dude.
Don't be so hard on yourself. I just stopped by to thank you for providing me with my escape.
That's kind of a cool effect. Chat,
but I have a lot of crimes to commit.
Wait!
And there's Piggy. Okay, I was wondering where he was going to show up.
Your time has come.
You're going to vaporize me?
Oh, can I do it?
Perhaps later. Piggy, you are a lowlife, selfish, worthless excuse for a life form.
Thank you, Emperor.
I knew he'd enjoy that.
He goes a long way with me.
Silence!
I'm silent. Zip the lip.
Good.
Oh, it even made a zip
now
sound. That's nice.
Proposal. I know you work both sides of the fence. You've helped me. And you've helped SPD.
Well, help SPD? Not exactly the words I'd choose.
How about treason?
I can explain.
Don't bother. The next 24 hours, you will spend in my unholiest, vilest pit of doom.
Oh. Well, you don't have to go all out for me.
I can't tell if he's joking or if he's looking forward to it.
You can decide which side you choose, SPD, or mine.
Well, I already choose yours, Emperor.
Morgana, prepare the vaporization.
Wrong answer? No, wait. I choose SPD?
Morgana, commence with vaporization.
Wait. I have an idea. I'll go to the Pit of Doom for 24 hours and think about it.
Oh, that's a good idea.
I've issued an all-points bulletin for Murloc.
Unfortunately, with his ability to transport through reflective surfaces, he's going to be very tough to find.
Well, he can't hide forever. Well, technically, he can. Like, in a puddle of water, or tin foil, or like a belt buckle, or like a glass of water.
We got it, Bridge.
Good job, man.
Sky feels horrible about this. I'm sure he thinks it's all his fault.
Murloc is crafty, but playing on Cadet Tate's emotions was particularly underhanded.
I think he had emotions.
Ooh.
Man, you should have told me about Murloc and my father.
Uh-oh.
I didn't feel it was in your best interest at the time.
You're probably right. The fact is, I blew it. I let my feelings get the best of me and Murloc got away. I should be demoted back to D Squad.
That's the decision for your team leader.
Uh-oh.
You told me your father fought to the end. And now you want to quit because you messed up once? I guess you're not much like your father after.
I don't know about once.
I say we split up. Hit the streets.
All right. You and Sid take the city plaza. Bridge Z, check out New Tech Center.
I'd like to help too.
Sam, you're back. I sent for him. You're going to need all the help you can get.
Cat, debrief me about Murloc. I'm ready to go.
Good timing. Sam and I will take the west side. Excellent. Be careful, all of you.
Yes, sir!
Emperor Grum, it's a true honor.
Of course it is.
Murloc escaped maximum security. Isn't that cool?
It is.
It is very cool.
With your permission, I'll continue my work where I left off.
Your petty crimes don't interest me. I have much bigger plans. But it seems we have a common enemy in the Power Rangers.
Let me take care of the Rangers, and then we will both get what we want.
Keep your eyes peeled for anything weird, okay?
That looked like Bridge in the passenger seat.
Like that?
But that was not Z driving.
For me.
As a matter of fact, we are.
Then I'm pleased I've made your search a short one.
This isn't good.
Come along, little rangers.
Oh, how did he do that?
Commander, I've lost a signal on Carson and Delgado.
Something's wrong. I'll check with the others.
What did he do?
Cadets, anything suspicious?
No, it's all quiet on this end, sir.
We've lost contact with Bridge and Z.
Do you think I should go brunette?
No.
I'll take you the way you are.
Look out!
We meet again, Ranger. I see you're always on the job, just like your daddy.
That's right. And now you're gonna pay for all your crimes, including my father.
Oh, I wouldn't count on that.
Sky?
Okay.
What's happening? Come in.
Commander, they're gone.
This is going well.
Nothing around here either.
Swimmingly, you might say.
I don't even know where to start looking.
Let me save you some time.
What?
This is too easy.
Freeze!
What?
SPD!
Commander!
How did he know? Oh, probably figured he's going after the Rangers. Duh.
Get out of here!
But we can help!
Now! Come back!
It's only a matter of time, Ranger.
Okay, so the things on his chest open up.
No trace of them at all. And no response from their morphers.
I'm certain Murloc's got them, but how?
I gotta go back out and find them.
No, we can't afford to lose you as well. Sam, he will have a hard time detecting you in your light form. Continue your search and let us know if you find anything.
Yes, sir!
Cat, keep looking.
Back so soon, Murloc.
I told you I'd take care of the Rangers. They'll be trapped in my reflective dimension.
Oh, nice.
Hold on. There are only four Rangers here.
Yeah, you forgot the Red Ranger and the Omega Ranger.
And the Shadow. There's seven Rangers this year.
In my own way.
Oh, okay.
But to complete our deal, you have to bring me the last two Rangers.
But Emperor...
I said, bring them to me.
As you wish.
Broodwing, give our friend a little help.
Not a problem. And it will only cost you...
I've given you enough!
Ooh.
This one is on the house.
Again? You just did that. Oh, that's cool looking.
We can't send out the Megazord without the other Rangers.
I bet Sam wouldn't mind if I borrowed his Mega Max cycle.
Do it!
I'll bring it online.
SPD! Emergency!
Ooh, they slowed him down for that. That was weird.
We need you to cover Jack for backup assistance.
SPD! Emergency! All over it! Uniform cycle!
This will be interesting.
That kind of speed.
I think I can handle it.
So, did they make a new set, or does this actually happen in the tech? In the Deca Ranger.
Megazord mode.
Using some odd angles. Who's piloting the robot? Jeez, look at all the fire. Oh, a blue head. Nope, that's Sentai footage. Ooh, I don't know what that was, but that was weird looking.
Looks like I'm gonna have to get an army action.
How? How is Omega supposed to get in on the action? Oh, it's actually going to work this time. He even knew how to do the motion. Not bad.
I'm glad that's over.
Huh. But,
Murlock.
It's time. I was gonna say, oh no! What in the world? He sucked up the whole Megazord?
I get it. His two mirrors make an infinite reflection that traps people inside. I got to break them out.
He can drive up walls. Okay.
Welcome.
All right, Murlock, let them go.
You seem to know who I am, but I've never met you.
Then let me introduce myself. I'm the one who's going to send you back to prison.
And just who is this new ranger that thinks he can fight me?
Ha! I'm the force from the future. Yeah! SPD Omega Ranger!
A ranger from the future. What a prize. No wonder Grum wants me to capture you.
You've got it wrong. It's you who is coming with me. Now let my friends go.
Why don't you come and get them?
No problem.
I wonder if this is more of a Omega, or I'm sorry, Becca break focus in the Sentai.
It's over, Ranger.
Jeez. Why isn't he sucking him up?
The future doesn't look good for you.
Omega Morpher! Electro Moon!
Nice try.
Well, that's cheating.
Murlock! You're a coward! Show yourself!
Look.
What?
Look at your fate.
Guys! Oh no. I gotta get them out of there. How? Think!
It's time for you to join your friends.
That's not gonna happen. Come and face me.
Oh, that was actually kind of cool. I was wondering if that would happen.
To complete my set of rangers to present to the Emperor.
Tell Grum the rangers are not going anywhere.
Sam!
Hold on!
What exactly was that? He's got to use the Rever thing.
You got him.
I'm through playing. Come on.
This is another one of those rather smooth transitions between American and Sentai footage. Not quite the same as Shadow Ranger Battle in Shadow, but it's not bad. It's just it's a little sunnier in New Zealand than it was in Japan. Dang.
Come on, Omega, you can do it.
Sorry, Rangers. He put up a good fight. Now he'll be joining you.
Ah, nice. Broke the glass.
It's all over.
He was playing possum.
All
right. Hey, and the Megazord came back too. That's nice.
You guys okay?
Yeah. This clown once and for all.
Foolish Rangers. Don't you realize if you catch me, I'll only escape again. Ask him. He's worthless, just like his father was.
That's just the lowest. Sky's dad was an amazing ranger.
Yeah, and so is he. He's the best.
Right. We're all proud to fight by his side.
How touching.
Wow. Look at that. It
takes to defeat me.
We'll see about that. Here. Take it.
Oh, this is a first, guys.
Right that you bring him in. Do for your father. You sure? Go for it.
Maybe he won't hold it right.
This one's for you, Dad.
SPD, emergency!
He gets a brand new morphing sequence.
I don't care what color you are.
This is the first time one ranger has used another ranger's powers. My only question is it the normal Red Ranger suit actor, or is it the Blue Ranger suit actor in the red suit?
Give it your best shot.
Yeah, he wouldn't be so bad as a Red Ranger.
What?
Although why this Murloc guy isn't escaping through a window, I don't know, but okay. Wow, did you see everything fly off? Hope no one got hurt. Someone should really go pick up the card. You're gonna give the Morpher back?
Did you enjoy that, Piggy?
Hey, Piggy's back!
I see you've survived the pit.
Oh, it was awful. The spiders, snakes, the smell. The horrors I saw.
Can I go back?
But enough of the good stuff. I realize that you are the one true leader. I hand you my life, my allegiance. I will do everything in my power to help you bring down SPD.
Excellent.
Uh-oh.
Morgana, this is the birth of our new assault on planet Earth.
Murloc is being jettisoned to the containment facility on Varanox 12.
Perfect. There's not a ray of sunlight on that planet.
Hence no reflections. So, no chance for him to escape.
Good work, Rangers.
Pretty bright for a planet with no sunlight.
And Sky, I apologize for not filling you in on all the details. You are a fine ranger, and I will not make that mistake again.
Thank you, sir.
Oh, he still has the helmet?
Is that... my dad's.
Well, I know he would have been proud of you if he could have seen you in action today.
In a weird way, I felt he was with me.
Ah.
Thanks. I owe you one.
Ah, it's all good, man. So, how did it feel to finally become the Red Ranger?
Being red was great, but I'm proud to be the Blue Ranger.
Really?
Yeah. You know, Jack, heroes come in all colors.
Aww. That's cool. So, I remember back in the day when this was airing, using the Time Force suit for Sky's dad. There was a lot of people wondering if that was supposed to be Wes, and if so, who's the mom? Since you don't see the mom either. Obviously, it isn't. But it is kind of weird. Like, how much time was there between the end of Time Force and all this stuff happening. Anyway, I remember back in the day, because of the suit that they used for this, there was a lot of speculation on if this was supposed to be Wes as Skye's dad. A few things. Number one, the name's wrong. Second, who would be the mom? Could it be Jen? They're not even allowed to kiss. I don't know if they're allowed to make babies. But the time frame is weird for this, you know? Because Time Force occurred in the present day of 2001, and SPD occurs in 2025. That's only 24 years. So Skye would have had to have been probably born about the time that Time Force took place. So I don't know. It's one of those things that they don't really explain. I guess they kind of tried setting it up in Cosmic Fury a little bit to help explain why there's so many aliens, but it still doesn't explain the whole Rangers we don't know about thing. Especially since Ninja Storm thought that, or at least Tori in Ninja Storm thought that Rangers weren't real. Anyway, I want to thank you all for listening to me go on for this extra long episode. We're over an hour. But next time on an all-new episode of Ranger Chronicles. And we'll be watching the two-part SWAT. So until then, I hope you all have a wonderful week.
And may the power protect
you. Thank you for listening to Ranger Chronicles. Feedback for the show can be sent to prchronicles@gmail.com. Or feel free to leave a comment on the show's posting at powerrangerchronicles.com. Ranger Chronicles is now on Patreon. If you'd like to support the show, please visit patreon.com/rangerchronicles for more information. All images and music heard on the show are copyright the respective copyright holders and are used for entertainment purposes only. No infringement is intended. This show is dedicated to everyone, both in front of the camera and behind the scenes, who have worked to bring us Power Rangers since 1993. Ranger Chronicles is a proud member of the Two True Freaks Internet Radio Network. Please be sure to stop by twotruefreaks.com to check out more great shows. Thank you, and may the power protect you.